I've spent quite a bit of time showing you the brackets workspace and how things work. It's finally time to start using brackets to do what it was made for, writing code. Before I start, I want to point out this icon right here that's indicating a new version of brackets is available. I'm using 0.42, and 0.43 was released while I was on vacation. I haven't downloaded it yet on this computer, and I will do that on my own time. It won't affect this lesson at all. I'll start with adding some content to the pc.html file. I'll turn on the live preview first. I'll start with a div with a class of main. Notice how brackets is showing the code hints. As soon as I type C for class, I can see that attribute in the code hints and just hit enter because it was highlighted. Then it gives me an equal sign and two double quotes, and it puts my cursor inside of the quote so I can just type the class name. As soon as I type the greater than symbol to finish the tag, the closing tag is output, and again, my cursor is put in the correct spot for typing inside the tag. I'll add an H2 heading for workspace now. After that header, I'll add another div with a class of shortcuts. Sometimes you might lose the code hinting if you backspace or do something else. When that happens, you can hit Ctrl plus spacebar to bring back the code hinting. And this shortcut is the same regardless of your operating system. I'll type the rest of the code now. If you want to work along with me, you can type in the code yourself, or you can copy some of it from the gist I have linked to in the lesson notes. I'll be pasting in some of the code myself. The spacing will probably work better if you copy from the raw code. You will note that these are all the PC shortcuts and not the Mac shortcuts, even though I'm working on a Mac right now. I'll be creating a Mac page of shortcuts later, and we'll use some find and replace features of brackets to do this. As I mentioned in an earlier lesson, the Mac shortcuts are usually similar to the PC shortcuts, just replacing command for control, but sometimes they're quite different. We'll talk about these differences when necessary. When pasting in code, it's best to have your cursor at the beginning of the line so the first line is properly aligned. There is an extension to let it go in the correct spot, but I'm sticking to vanilla brackets for now. Notice that because I missed the beginning UL tag, my live preview icon goes hot pink, and I get this indicator on the line with the closing tag telling me there's an error. Also, the live preview is not working and didn't update with the new content. This is because there's an error. If I fix it, all will look well. When you're typing, if you forget to put quotes, parentheses, or brackets around what you're typing, you can add them easily, but you need to have auto close braces turned on first. That option is found at the bottom of the edit menu. It's turned off by default when you first install brackets. I guess some people might not like having it turned on for various reasons, but I always want this turned on. So if I type the class name without the code hinting and I forget the quotes, I can select the word, and if I type a quote, it will automatically surround the word with quotes. This option will also automatically close your parentheses and brackets when you're typing JavaScript and CSS. Next, I'd like to add the brackets logo to the top of the page inside the main header. The code hinting in brackets has a feature that's not in all code editors that I really like. It finds your external files when you're adding something like an image and gives you the code hinting to add it quickly. I'll type as little as possible and use as much code hinting as I can. IM will get me image, space, and then SR for source. That gives me the attribute in quotes. Then brackets is very helpful and it shows me all my files and directories, and I can pick the directory where the images are. I'll type I, then pick image. Then, even better, I can see all the files in the directory and I can type the first character or arrow down to pick one. I'm going to pick the SVG version of the image. This type of code hinting will work whenever you add an attribute to a tag that references something external like a source attribute or an href, so it's helpful when adding style sheets, images, script tags, and anchor links. In the next lesson, I'll talk about the important keyboard shortcuts to know when you're writing and editing your code.